Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the happy hour, the success happy hour experience with the Drunken Grape. We have an awesome show today. We are talking about being a digital nomad, self-employment. How do you tackle that when traveling or gallivanting around the globe? Well, there's a lot of things you can do. One of them, of course, is you definitely need the assistance of virtual assistants. It's pretty hard to keep up with bookkeeping and everything else as you're hopping from country to country, or in the case of some of my guests here where they have properties around the globe and you're going to different spots. You know, it's always exciting to break down such brilliant topics, and I'm welcoming back Charmie Gal and Francois Lanthier. They've been reoccurring guests on this show. We're going to talk about this. We're diving right in. How to be a digital nomad effectively in our globalized world today. And I tell you what, if you are an entrepreneur, you definitely want to tune in, listen to this, because some tidbits of information, even if you want to stay in a central location, will be of definite advantage to you. So welcome back, Charmy, Francois. How are you both doing? It's great to have you back on the show.
Thanks, Rob.
Amazing.
Yeah, so what have you been up to? You two have been doing some pretty cool things. So let's just get a background into what got you into this. I know that you co-host live videos. You talk a lot about virtual assistants. I believe you've partnered together to build this entity up. Talk to me a little bit about it. What got you started? What motivated you on this one? And where's it heading?
Yes, I'll let Charmy start, but a bit of a crazy story, Charmy, if you could say how we got started with all this.
Well, I think it started, we're both real estate investors, right, Rob? And we needed some help and coaches as well. We both do coaching, and we tried to find a very good virtual assistant to help us, because at some point in your business, you can't do everything by yourself. So, and you know, we've known each other because of real estate, and Francois and I are talking about how it's so hard to find stable and very good qualified virtual assistant, and we're like, maybe we should have our own. And that's how it started, actually. It's from a pain point, right, Francois?
Yes, and now we get the cream of the crop. And actually, just before this recording, we were still talking about some of our recruits and how it's hard. They ghost us, they disappear. So wow. That's why we started this business, is to mm-hmm. get those people that are responsive, have good internet, reliable power, because we are hiring overseas. And in Canada, we take it for granted, good internet, good power. Over there, it's not their fault. It's the infrastructure. So we need those teams with backups, and then the work etiquette as well. So yeah, it was our pain point. And now Charmy and I, we get to pick the best of the best. And then we train them as well mm-hmm. for our clients. So of course, it's a bit self-serving at first. Why not? And then we can let others enjoy some of the best as well and move on to other talents. And we're shocked by some of the people, like technical skills and the things they're pushing us to do. It's just amazing.
Wow, that's cool. I mean, my concern, I've been approached by anybody who has any kind of business or professional presence on LinkedIn, for instance. You get hit up by VAs all the time.
Yes.
And, you know, often they come from India, Bangladesh, the Philippines. And my big concern is two things. How reliable are they? How reliable is the work? Maybe even three. Are their skills legit? And how are they going to get it done? You know, and you nailed it on the head. Like, what's the infrastructure like around them? Because, you know, we take it for granted that we have 5G networks all over the place. You can stream in 4K video if you got the bandwidth for it, or if you really want to rack up that kind of file size to store later on. But a lot of these places are like almost on the equivalent of dial-up internet still. And, you know, how do you rely on that? So where do you go? So what centers in developing countries, or third world countries and developing countries, or countries that are getting mostly developed, like Costa Rica, for instance, where would they be centered? Would it be major city centers that at least supply proper internet services to do these jobs adequately? Because, I mean, things that are of great importance for an entrepreneur are cost, functionality, and efficiency.
Yes. So I'd like to say, first of all, I call them all developing countries because third world, in my opinion, is now including Canada. So we won't digress too much into that because I have traveled and I'm like,
we have digressed. Sure. Canada's not really that great anymore. It's true.
But no, we'll get exactly.
Off that. We'll get off that horse, but that's
it. I'm true. Getting off that horse, but I want to correct that. But then the internet, yes, larger centers tend to be better, but actually some smaller places too. It depends. Charmie, that's kind of why we associated. She's originally from the Philippines.
Yes.
Many years ago, although Charmie's like 25. Somehow when she was a baby, she got to Canada. We're speaking and everything. So anyway, she told me if we build a team, we need to spread out that team all over the country. And Charmy, maybe you can say why, what happens there in the Philippines.
For sure. And actually, like in Asia, Rob, the internet quality is actually very good. We just
really
they use a lot of streaming. So the quality is good. The issue in Asia is because of all the other things they can't control, which is bad weather. They're in that, you know, Pacific Ring of Fire where there's typhoons, earthquakes. Those are the things you have to watch out for. So I knew that right away when we're creating our team. So that's why I told Francois, we have to make sure our team are not located in the same area. Because usually when there's an earthquake, you know, it won't be in the same location. So that's the first thing we did for the VAs. They're not located in the same areas. So if there's one thing that's happening in one region, hopefully the other region doesn't have that issue. And they all have a backup generator and backup laptop because we already knew that's an issue. So as long as you know what you're up against, you can actually make sure that there's controls in place. So we've taken care of that already.
Do you help supply them with any equipment at all, or do they have to bring on their own equipment? Because, you know, these countries are poor on average. I mean, we're not doing great in Canada either right now, but, you know, these countries, to buy $1,000 or $500, $1,000 laptops, not the most accessible thing.
Most of them are really experienced, so.
Yeah, well, that's it. The people we choose come with their own equipment. They do have, I'd say, fairly high-tech stuff. And, mm-hmm. of course, in Canada, we forget, but we pay a premium for everything. There's a lot of taxes built in to our products. I just went to Malaysia.
Excessive.
And I went to the Apple store and those places, and things were a lot cheaper than here because yes. they're not paying tariffs and export and import. And things are made, let's be frank, in China and Malaysia and Hong Kong and different areas. And that's very close yes. to the Philippines. So
Apple products are actually more affordable. They're cheaper there, Apple
that's
products.
It.
I'm surprised. Mm-hmm. Are they much cheaper? Because it's Apple sort of fixes the prices globally. I mean, you're going to pay similar prices in rupees or whatnot yeah. for...
It's really that it's the taxes.
It's probably, yeah, you probably shave off at yeah. least 13% taxes.
I'd say like a 25% off. Maybe it's volume as well. I mean, you're mm-hmm. dealing in much larger cities.
Yes.
The capital of Philippines, Manila, 22,000 people per square kilometer. So it's one of
wow.
the densest cities in the world.
Yes.
So
wow.
it's a different thing, and people think dial-up. No, I saw 5G pretty much everywhere. But again, like Charmy said, it's the elements. We don't control that.
That's
and
it.
It's starting to happen here too. We have forest fires, different things. So how will that
ice
affect
storms.
Our grid?
Yes.
You know, in the middle of a winter, you can look out and like, well, hey, where did the 3 inches of ice come from? You know, and it does happen here
exactly.
too. And you're right. I mean, now we're having forest fires. I think some of that might be arson. But it doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. It's happening and it's disruptive. I mean, this summer alone here, it was smog central in Ottawa. June was ruined by a clay mm-hmm. haze of fires. It smelled like a campground as soon as you went outside. So, I mean, but these are all factors to consider. It's interesting
yes.
you bring this up because when people think VAs, they think cyberspace. Oh, I'm just going to get that done. Not a problem. But it is a problem because these people are actually in physical locations. They're not floating around in space or some spot where, you know, it's a constant and you're not hiccuped by any kind of weather patterns. Whereas here, inclement weather can be very destructive. I'm glad you brought that up. That's a very interesting thing to talk about, you know, and it's definitely something of note and of interest for sure. So, how's it been going with the growth of clients? Because I think the biggest concern you nailed on the head is reliability mm-hmm. and whether those skill sets measure up to par or not.
Yeah, so we've all worked with all our VAs. So we test them out first, Rob. We actually work on small projects, and then if we find that the quality is there, we give them bigger projects. And I think you need to do that. You need to start with something small. Don't give them a big project right away, because if the quality is not there, then you're screwed, really. You wasted your time and your money. So I do recommend start with smaller projects. And I think this is what's different as well. When clients deal with us, they know that we've personally worked with a virtual assistant. It's somebody we know. I think that's one thing that's really hard. Like, these are, you know, people are like, they're strangers. You have no idea who you're working with. You know, you have no idea the quality of work. You don't even know if they really have the skill set that they're saying, right? So.
Sure. And it's, but at the same time, what kind of savings are people looking at over your typically exorbitant costs in the West? Like, what would you save? How much are we talking? Like, one quarter of the cost, one third, a half, a tenth?
Yeah, I'd say actually we're not focusing on price for sure. But of course, you're not paying benefits, you're not paying vacation time, you're not paying sick time. So those are all big savings.
They are.
Also, you can do more project based. So if you want a website, we're going to give you a quote and here it is. And that's what we do. So I know in Canada it can be done as well, but you're saving a lot compared to building a website from a Canadian builder. And then, of course, there's subscriptions. So we have bundles, which are amazing, because as an entrepreneur, normally you need a little bit of web design, a little bit of bookkeeping, a little bit of marketing.
Social media.
So, yeah, lots of social media. You need all that mix. Do you need six VAs? Like, how do you handle that? I've tried that and it's nuts. I was working for the VAs full time. So that's why we have these bundles. And then the virtual assistants pitch in and do all the little pieces. So you save quite a bit. Charmie, I'm sure you can add to this.
Yeah, for sure. So when we created these bundles, it came from a business perspective, really, because as a business, you need different things, right? But I do not like working with generalists, Rob, because that takes too long and you're very busy. So I'd rather pay somebody that knows the business that's going to take 2 hours than 10 hours. And that's what you're getting with us, is that if you need social media, you're working with a social media specialist. If you need technical VA, that's a technical VA. If you need bookkeeping, they're all accountants, actually. So not only are you saving in the cost, which for us, we're more in the middle ground, because we want to make sure the quality is there. We don't want to get the cheapest VA, because then we're wasting your time and our time. We do take a lot of time to train them and make sure that the quality is there. So you work with the business and we grow with you. Like, if, you know, when you have your business, it's never the same, right? It's always changing. It's always fluctuating. So we work with that, and you work with specialists, so you don't spend time training and
correcting.
We're so busy. So
what are you, I'm just going
to
bring up
the handoff.
Oh, for sure. I'm just going to bring up the website. What is it again? Your virtual assistants.
It's innovatevacorp.com.
InnovateVACorp.com.
And our website was made by our VA.
Yes. Yeah, so we really lead by example. We don't, Charmie and I, like, we do a lot, but we also don't do a lot. Like, the VAs even manage our meetings. We had our monthly meeting. It was all held by our VAs. That's the goal, Charmie. It's to delegate and move on. To the beach and margaritas.
That's cool, man. Well, I'm going to bring it up and feature it for 1 second, because I think it's very important.
Sure.
You know, I think we need to showcase these things. It's critical. You know, it's where people can find you. And I think you got a pretty cool video. So we're going to bring this up. There you guys are explaining it away. I love it. What a slick looking site. So you have Innovate Virtual Assistance, ladies and gentlemen, is the name of the business. I should have showcased that to start things off, but that's okay. We're going to put that in the show notes. What a slick-looking presentation. It talks about being a real estate investor, coach, or entrepreneur looking for long-term virtual assistance. Now, with the growth of global investing, the West is declining right now. Places like Canada are a complete mess financially. Tons of Canadians are exiting. A lot of them are, of course, turning into real estate to do so. If you're watching this, this is for you. If you are a social media expert, you're doing something that relies on a virtual platform for business, You can live anywhere in the world. Why wouldn't you? Why would you not attach yourself to this? You definitely need to reach out to Francois and Charmie on this. I mean, this site is cool, guys. I'm just going to bring it up and just get into it. I mean, we've got the, I didn't want to play it with the audio to interrupt things, but it gives you an idea of what's there. You have about, you have services. So I saw in here the VIP package. You know, I'm going to play this. Oh. I stopped sharing this for a second. We're going to get back to that. But
we need a VA, you know, to fix this.
Yes, there you go. So it's actually not that bad. The beauty of Riverside FM is you can actually control this really well. There we are. So there's you, Charmie. I'm going to just bring up the tab.
Hello, welcome to Innovate. I'm so glad that you're here. So whether you're a solopreneur, a small business owner, or an inspiring entrepreneur, you're at the right place. It's never too late nor too early to start building your dream team. Having worked at corporate for over 20 years, I know the power of having a great team behind you so that you can focus on being the CEO of your business and being the visionary instead of being bogged down by all the administration, tracking your expenses.
So anyway, you know, I just stopped sharing that, but this is just brilliant. I love it. Innovate Virtual Assistance. It's what an awesome piece of business. You know what? On the happy half the hour note, I know you guys don't have drinks in your hand yet, but I don't want to share this with you. Cheers to the audience. I have a Ruffino Chianti Classico Reserva. This is aged at least 2 years in barrel. This is in the higher standards. I think it's a $33 bottle at the LCBO. Ruffino is one of the longstanding producers of Chianti and of great quality wine within Tuscany itself, or Toscana, which would be the region that this comes from. Now, the history behind Chianti Classico, you're going to see that on the back of the bottle, there's the Gallo Negro, or the Black Rooster. This is from the La Liga di Chianti, established in 1384. There were two superpowers at war at the time. There was Firenze, which is Florence, and Siena. And these two city-states slugged it out for hundreds of years. Ultimately, Florence prevailed, I believe, in 1555. And what the Gallo Negro was, the Black Rooster, is knights were sent out with roosters to determine where the territory would begin and end between these two superpowers as they fought over the Chianti region itself. Wine, of course, a coveted crop, had a lot of financial benefits to it. What happened was, in Florence, they starved the rooster for days. And when at the set of dawn, they let the rooster free. The other one was well-fed. It didn't fly as aggressively. And the knights met up two-thirds of the way down or right outside of the walls of Siena, some 9 miles away. And Florence took this massive area of territory. So that's a bit of history behind this whole region. It's about 25,000 acres under vine. Chianti Classico only uses red grapes. This is 80% or more Sangiovese. There's actually a bit of Merlot and Cabernet Sauvignon in here as well. Lots of rich cherry on the nose. Very dry wine. Medium to medium plus bodied. You know, this goes really well with things like braised beef. Spaghetti bolognese, things like that. You can even have it with pizza if you had it with like a pepperoni pizza. So cheers to you. Cheers to you. The happy, happy hour.
Cheers.
Having my vodka and orange juice at 10 a.m., but no problem.
I know it's only about 10:30 in the morning, but this is delicious. So getting back to things.
It's interesting, the history in that. It's so cool, actually.
Yes. Wine, you got to remember, wine is thousands of years old. It goes back in some cases. I mean, the first commercial winery was found in Armenia in 4100. It dates back to like 4100 BC.
Whoa. Wow.
Amazing.
So the first real cultivation of grapes, it's a debate between China and the Wahu region, I believe in northeastern China, in the Henan province. There's a lot of beer was found there as well. Vines cultivated around the valley of the Yellow River. They're not too sure. And the stronger evidence points to Georgia in the Caucasus in eastern Europe. And that's 8,000 really where
years, I heard.
The cradle of the origins of modern day winemaking begin. That's
my ancestors,
documented.
I'm sure.
Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, and they still actually have, it's interesting because their wines are starting to penetrate the market here in North America. And they've had excellent wines for thousands of years. And we're only now starting to really delve into it in North America, because a lot of those grapes, all those bottles are bought up regionally before they never make it really far into the export market. It's quite incredible. But getting back to this now, and getting back to you, getting back to this brilliant virtual assistance company. Obviously, the best way to get hold of you is your contact information is on the site itself, I would believe. Then there's probably a form they can fill out as well. These things always have that. I imagine this is growing quite well for both of you.
It really is. And another way is our community. So we see Innovate Virtual Assistance as a community, both with our team and our clients. So we have a free Facebook group. People look us up, Innovate. I think it's Innovate Virtual Assistance. It's the group. Mm-hmm. And it's a great way to learn. There's some free stuff. Maybe you're not ready to pull the trigger yet. That's why we host all these lives. And we want to grow with other businesses. But it's exponential. Charmie and I, every meeting, we're like, we have a new team member. We have a new account. We need to do this. It's a lot, but it's wonderful. It's a nice experience. And we can't wait to bring on more people. And I love learning from, we learn from our clients. We teach them things. Just a nice two-way street.
That's very cool. And you're now living that part of the dream too. I mean, you're back in Ottawa for what, two more days packing things up. The house is sold. I think that's the last bits of vestibules of what's in that house that's yours. It's already sold, that home, right? You're out of it. Very short.
My house, was gone 2 months ago. This is an Airbnb that I'm renting. So nice. I don't own the books or anything, which is wonderful. I don't have to carry them.
Good little setup for video. But still, it's, good for you. And Charmy, are you going to embark on the same path? Are you going to get out of Canada and become a digital nomad too?
Well, that is at some point where we are planning that as well. Rob, for me, it's more than my children. I wanted them to finish school, for sure. I want to travel. I think after COVID, it really hit home that I miss traveling, and I want the kids to see how it is elsewhere. And that's another thing I find people don't think about. It's nice to show the other parts of the world to your children. And also, there's so much to learn. You know, people who never leave their I know some people who've never left their province. So,
listen, I used to come off the cruise line.
You're missing so much.
You're so right. I mean, I used to come off the cruise line industry, and the comment was I would see the same seats at the same bar, people filling those seats at the bar years later. I'm like, holy fuck, these people haven't done anything. Like, I've just visited 92 countries at this point. These people are still sitting there bitching about the same shit, not moving anywhere, doing the same crummy job that they don't like. And drinking overpriced crappy draft beer at the time. Now, beer, of course, the quality is light years better with the explosion of craft brewery movement. But getting back in the late 90s, that wasn't the case in the early 2000s. And what I realized is that, you know what? If you don't like Canada, you can just leave. If it's the taxes, the situation gets too brutal. You don't need a lot. You need a few $1,000 and you could be out the door. And you could reestablish your life somewhere else. You could just pack up and go.
And I just had a meeting earlier this morning with someone on this very topic. And a lot of people are scared, but you actually don't need that much money if you're willing to go to places that don't cost as much. Yes, your standard of living will change, but also the requirements and the stress will change as well. So you can offshore your life, and that's what we help our clients do as well. Even within Canada, you could move to a less expensive city, town, province. The options are endless. It doesn't have to mean leaving Canada, but it usually means leaving something more expensive, maybe to make it affordable until your business is afloat. Then you could circle back and go to Monaco or whatever you want. But at first, maybe look at more affordable options.
If you have bills and debts to pay them off elsewhere.
Or go bankrupt and leave.
Yeah. Or go bankrupt and leave. I wouldn't recommend that path necessarily, no. But it's but just pay your debts off. But I mean, there's more money to be made elsewhere. If you take a look, say if you're making 2/3 of what you were on paper in a foreign country, which is not hard to do in a lot of cases.
No.
But you're paying minimal taxes 1/3. Compared to what you were paying before. You're actually taking home more than you were in Canada. Now, if you factor in the substantially reduced cost of living, better food, cheaper food, fresher food, and much greater abundance, you know, looking at a place like Costa Rica, hydro and power bills, cell phone bills, a fraction of the cost, medical and dental, a fraction of the cost, you're actually way ahead at the end of the day leaving.
You can pay your debt faster and then be honest and live debt free, which is a big stress. So
and just move forward.
It applies to everything.
Getting to selling large ticket items like real estate, boats, whatever it might be, because large ticket items pay the best. It's a ticket or a move towards financial freedom is just start selling large ticket items because they have a huge commission attached to them. You sell a few of those, you can watch your bank account really grow really fast. There's a lot of ways to do it. You know, it's a pleasure talking with both of you because it's an eye opener. And for those that want hope, you know, Canada in particular, under Justin Trudeau, hope has been stripped off the minds of a lot of people. And now we've hit a new low by inviting a Nazi into the House of Commons. I don't know if you guys heard that. This is just insane that things are going on. But the hope, forget all that. The hope that you can really start a life as a digital nomad or taking your skill sets, particularly if you have trade skills, tech skills, sales skills, specialized hospitality skills. I know I can do wine tastings abroad now. That's really encouraging. Just go. The world is your oyster. And there are a lot of places that have similar or better healthcare to Canada. I mean, that's the biggest concern. And the other concern is safety. There's a lot of safe places around this planet, too. I've traveled to tons of them. I mean, as long as you don't go into the rough areas of the country, you're fine. Well, that holds true, too, in Canada. You could go to Jane and Finch. At Jane and Finch Street in Toronto and around that area and probably get shot at. I mean, it's an illusion to think that we have it all in the West. The world has grown by leaps and bounds now. Take advantage of it. Any parting thoughts on this as we close out, my friends?
I think that's what it is, Rob. I find people sometimes they focus so much on the issues they have and they don't think differently. There's so much options out there. You're not stuck where you are. You can definitely change. If you're not happy where you are, if you want to do something different, it really is up to you. You just have to make that decision to change it.
Yeah, an attitude really is altitude, as is belief, right?
Mm-hmm. It really is. Too. And even if maybe you like where you are, but you don't like your job, look for another job. We're still doing well right now. I know employment is going down slightly, but there's still lots of opportunities. Or start your own business, start a sideline, find a way, change your life. Life is short. Take action. Really plan it, of course, if you've got kids and debt and things. Don't just throw caution to the wind, but do a bit of planning and change it. Stop complaining, start doing. That's all. I'm quoting Elvis all the time now.
Oh, yeah.
And surround yourself with the right people. Because sometimes it's your environment.
That's actually one of the biggest things. And I look at it more, the glass is half full. I think life is very long. I think we're blessed as humans to have very long life. We're one of the longest lived creatures on the planet. Life is short if you don't maximize it.
That's it.
You know, and the other end of it is look around you. Look to the left and the right. Take stock of who you're associating with. Yes. If somebody's bringing in negative influences or naysayers, cut them immediately. Drop them like dead wood. Family members, even if they're not on your side, they're against you. Cut them. Mm-hmm. You know, it's almost like the Bible says that, you know, you serve one master, but you can't serve both. Well, it's the same thing. You can be of service and of association to a positive circle or a negative circle. It doesn't work that you can have. It doesn't work that you can say, oh yeah, most of my friends are positive, but this guy's a pain in the ass. It's like, no, if they're a pain in the ass, drive friend down. Out. You know, and it's the same thing with work, with your work environment. If it's a sticking point, move on. Get out there. Grow on your own. Listen, you two are just awesome and inspiring. You're pretty young. You know, I imagine you're in your 40s. You guys have accomplished so much. You inspire me. I'm a little older to step up and out, to really delve into real estate investing. You know, in some ways I'm starting from scratch. My girlfriend's not, but I am. And it's because I just had different areas of life taking on at the time. But it's to know that there's so much going on globally that you can really take advantage of, that steps you out of how lobbyists influence to allow big corporations to dictate the West, to smother the growth of small business, because it is a very nasty climate here. Other places around the world are wide open. They welcome you with arms. I mean, you know, on a parting note, Costa Rica, it's a point of very big interest of mine, getting into the real estate market there, you know, and working with you and Tammy is going to be really exciting, Francois. Isn't that one of the countries where there's actually, it's pretty wide open to make money?
It is, yes. Of course, you need, there's bureaucracy, there's certain things.
There always is.
You can't get away with it.
But that's what makes it more fun. It's like grape and wine, like grapes. If the wines are just as is, they're grapes, they're table grapes. But when you press them, you're the expert here.
Yeah, you, when they're pressed and vinified, it depends what type of cask, what blend of old and new oak, you know,
that's
what kind
bureaucracy.
Of yeast, what kind of yeast they use, the you know, what kind of standards that they have to go through. They have to go through laboratory analysis. Like, this is a DOCG wine. This actually has to go through a blind tasting panel every year on top of laboratory analysis to guarantee its authenticity. I mean, that's
there you go. So just it's just like some restrictions and rules.
Yeah, I heard it best. You know, to close things out, it's whether the bureaucracy works with some benevolence and accord
that's
with
it.
What you're doing or not. Are they
if the great the bureaucracy, good, you can make good wine.
Yeah, and is the bureaucracy interested in you thriving in business and they create a lower tax environment to attract more revenue? Or are they a high tax mature economy like Canada that money is just going off to politicians and government officials to squander it? It depends on where you're at.
Exactly.
Well, listen, you guys have been awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, make sure to subscribe to this channel. I've done a lot of things backwards today, but you got to change up the show. Make sure to like the video. Make sure to share the content. Make sure to check out Innovate Virtual Corp. Did I say it right?
Innovate Corp.
What is it again? Innovate.
InnovateVAcorp.com.
Okay, perfect. Well, check this out. We're going to have the show notes in there. Contact Francois and Charmie. You know, they're also prolific in the world of real estate investing. There's many things you can look for with them. You guys have been awesome guests. Once again, thank you very much for being part of the Success Happy Hour. This is the Digital Nomad Happy Hour. Whatever you decide to do, ladies and gentlemen, this is Rob, Francois, and Charmie from the Drunken Grape. Have a terrific day. We'll be right back.